Hi guys, so welcome back to another episode of Joyous Fishing. So I know it's been a long time since we uploaded any video. Yeah, so that's because we are recently very busy with schoolwork and outside work. Yeah, so my apologies if the video don't come like as regularly as they used to. Yeah, but we are working on it. We are still coming out when we have the time to fish. Yeah, so just be patient with us. So anyway, today we are here at Bedok Jetty. And we'll be here surf casting for maybe a few hours only lah. We don't really have much time. Yeah, we need to wake up early tomorrow. So the bait for today is only gelong sotong and a bit of octopus. Yep, so we'll get set up and start fishing and update you guys again later. Okay, onto something on the light rod. Fish. Never swallow. Okay, so we think there's a fish on this. We are not too sure. It's been bouncing the tip. Yeah. Maybe reel down and strike on him. Just got a moray view. Yeah, so just be very careful lah. This one, when they bite you right, it's really very painful. You can still see the scar on my finger lah, when I got bit by one. Yeah, this is the one that got me 4 stitches. So anyway, they strike my rig. I cut everything out and fortunately the hook came out. So anyway, this one's going back lah. We don't need bait today. Yeah, we have plenty of sotong lah. So I just go throw it back. It's still very active lah. Bye-bye. Yeah, so just be careful, always use pliers, okay, and honestly don't try to save your rig, just cut the rig. Yeah, it's not worth it trying to take out then after you get injured or what. Yeah, so yeah, please be careful and use pliers. Okay, onto something. Yeah. No, not very sure what it is. Strong. Ooh,
MJ.
Hello, Abim. I want to strong yeah. The handline fly like one thing yeah. Wow. It's just in the corner. Oh,
this is from here.
Ah, right. So
big.
So this is what we found inside the fish. So you can see it's an old hook. It rusted off. Yeah, so this actually lodged inside his gills lah. Then you can still see the blood down here. Yeah, the old dried blood. Yeah. So it's an old hook. It's rusted until it broke. Yeah, so this generally what happens when you, like let's say if the fish is cut hook or what, then you cut off the line right. Then you can see it's connected to a short piece of line. Yeah, so sometimes the hook can rust off and the fish will actually do fine. Yeah.
Okay. It looks redder now.
Let me take some pictures on the floor.
On the floor.
Okay, so that was a mangrove jack or mangrove snapper. Yeah, we call Tia Zhuo or Anka Tia. So, that one was barely hooked. Yeah, when it came up, I'm not sure if you all can see from the video, but it was hanging from like one skin on the lid. Yeah, and there was another line stuck inside his gills that the hook had rusted up. Yeah, so that was quite a good size. Yeah, I think 1.5 to 2 kilos around there. So we are definitely keeping that to eat. Yeah, so that's all we have for now. Yeah, we are playing surf cast, but mainly it's just small fish and crabs stealing the bait. Yeah, so we will keep fishing, update you guys again later. Alright guys, so a quick update. Here is one of our handlines and you can see it has been well chilled. Okay, so this is a very obvious signature of a puffer fish. Yeah, you can see the line has been flattened la, and chilled la. So this 100 pound line, so it means this puffer fish have pretty sharp teeth. Yeah, and it's quite a sizable one la. This was a 2-0 hook. Yeah, so anyway, it's not just this handline. There's been like 4 handlines that's been chewed through. Yep, so it's a little bit irritating, and therefore we shall now replace it with a wire. Yeah, so I have this length of wire down here. Yeah, to a nice big red mustard hook. Yeah, and a piece of kelong sotong la. So hopefully the pufferfish don't get through my wire. Yeah, and I'll update you guys again later. Okay, on to something on the handline. Oh! Wow! Oh my gosh! That is a nice stingray. You didn't get up? Okay. Careful ah. Careful ah, the tail ah, tail ah, tail ah. Ooh! Wow! That is a very nice blue-spotted fantail ray. Unfortunately, it swallowed my hook all the way inside its stomach. Yeah, so I think this one, I think we need to eat it. Hey, careful, yeah, I do. Yeah, we probably gonna eat it, it's a good size, okay. And I cannot get the hook out. Yeah, even like I take out the sotong. Yeah, you can see it's all the way into its stomach. Yep. Okay, so that was a blue-spotted fantail ray. Yeah, so it's Tenura limna. Yeah, this species of ray frequent more of coral places as compared to other species of ray which prefer like sandy or muddy ground. Yeah, so that was actually pretty good size, adult size la, for that kind of stingray. They don't grow that big. The maximum is maybe about 3 to 4 kilos ish. Yeah, so that one was caught on a mustard big red. So actually it was quite shocking, it's a 3-0 hook and the ray actually just soloed the whole thing. Yeah, because usually when we catch rays, they don't actually solo the hook. It's actually on the mouth or else maybe at the side. Yeah, so that was quite interesting even though I couldn't get the hook out. So we ended up keeping the ray to eat. Yeah, anyway it was a good size stingray. Yeah, so actually it's a pretty good day honestly, although our surf rods are very quiet. Yeah, so we'll keep fishing for a while more. Hopefully we get something. If not, we'll pack up and yep, update you guys again later. Alright guys, so we've come to the end of our short session. The time now is about 12 a.m. Yeah, so we are both very tired. I think it's time to call it a day. We've caught quite a few fish. Mainly is the mangrove jack and the blue-spotted fantail ray. Yeah, the rest were just like those stockfish, eel, those small fish we just let go lah, yeah. We do have time to play with those today. Yep, so anyway, hope you guys enjoy yourself and yeah lah, hope to see you guys in the next episode.